Hai semua, selamat datang kembali di Titi Ahmadi England Channel. Ayo ikut kami tur di Royal Pavilion. Dalam video sebelumnya sudah saya jelaskan bahwa Royal Pavilion adalah dulunya rumah musim panas Raja George IV. Yuk kita lihat bagian dalam Royal Pavilion dan melihat seperti apa kamar Raja George di abad 18.
Ini lukisannya koleksi King George IV dan ruangan ini sama dengan dalam lukisan tersebut.
Big. This book I made coronation. I made a book of painting all things that happened.
Buku besar ini dibuat atas perintah King George, Raja George, untuk menaruh semua hasil lukisan tentang istana ini.
Guys, Royal Pavilion di Brighton sangat layak dikunjungi bagi kalian yang tertarik dengan sejarah, seni, dan arsitektur. Royal Pavilion sangat unik dan berbeda dengan istana-istana lain di Inggris.
Even the carpet. The carpet's done.
I need to reading from there. Here. What they said, the saw, the saloon was created in 1787.
Reception.
Formal reception. Oh, yeah.
So, anybody who came, came in here first.
This is not bedroom, this is the apartment. Nah, kita sekarang berada di kamarnya King George. Tinggi. King George. No, that's only decoration. Kamarnya King George itu tempat tidurnya. Dr. Matthew Tierney or something, I don't know. Look, there are the door over there on the wall. Kamar tidurnya. Well, oh, ini perpustakaan, ruang baca. Oh, door to here. They, because they can close the
big door and use a small door.
globe. Wait a moment.
There's a boat there.
Hmm?
It's a boat.
Yeah. That's the door. That's door to outside, honey. Oh, look at this. This look like rantang.
It wouldn't be. But single.
Yeah.
Obviously, it wasn't very warm in here then. Blankets.
Yeah. How many? 10.
The saloon bottle is the highest part of the pavilion. Looking down from it, you can see the roof of the pavilion. There's amazing little spaces up here, narrow walkways and tiny doors, which lead into the pavilion domes. Here you can see John Wayne building to support the dome above the saloon. Because Nash could not support the additional story to new onion-shaped roof and existing external doors, he devised a cage of iron columns encircling the walls. It was a daring technical stroke, and Nash experimented widely with new materials on an unprecedented scale. It was one of the first domestic uses of iron, and previously only been used in bridges or factory buildings. In the dome above the banqueting room, you can see how the magnificent chandelier is fastened. Suspended from this central point, the chandelier was 30 feet high and weighed nearly a ton. The Royal Pavilion has a very fascinating history, and we hope you enjoy discovering it on your visit today. For 200 years, the pavilion has been bound to the identity of Brighton. Colourful and often controversial, Brighton has grown around the iconic symbol of the pavilion into the city it is today. Designed for entertaining and pleasure, the Royal Pavilion was not expected to last two centuries. Our dedicated team of conservators help ensure present and future generations can enjoy this spectacular palace. You can help us to conserve and protect the Royal Pavilion by becoming a member of the Royal Pavilion. For more information, pick up a leaflet or ask in the shop for details. Here's to be Indian on the outside, Chinese on the inside. It is actually only a Western interpretation of the East. George never visited either, but loved the exotic, fantastical vision of both. Britain was a very powerful nation at this time, and George may have seen himself as emperor of the world. During George's visits to the Royal Pavilion, he would play host to many guests who would stay for several days. They would enjoy lavish hospitality, and the building would come alive with banquets, balls, and concerts. Progressive ill health and the demands of the monarchy meant that George's visits became more infrequent. His last visit was in 1827, 3 years before he died. His brother, William IV, succeeded him as king and reigned until 1837. His niece, Victoria, then became queen. Queen Victoria used the pavilion as a royal residence until 1845, when she decided to sell it. She felt she was constantly being stared at by the public, and it was too public a place for her family. 143 wagons of the interior furnishings and decorations were removed and taken to London for the Royal Collection. In 1849, a bill was brought before Parliament, which would have allowed the demolition of the pavilion and the selling of the site for redevelopment. This measure was opposed by a public petition and a determined campaign led by the town clerk of Brighton, Lewis Slight. The pavilion was eventually bought by the town for £53,000. It remains the only British royal palace not owned by the state or the crown. Within a year of purchase, the pavilion opened to the public. Attempts were made to redecorate the main rooms in the original style, and Queen Victoria returned many items, such as chandeliers, paintings, and figurines.
The detail of the stairs.
And even this is
bamboo. What is sculpture?
Yeah.
It's wood. Jadi istana ini di luar tampak seperti masjid bangunan dari Timur Tengah atau Arab, tapi di dalamnya semua ilustrasinya seperti dari Cina.